Soil is the bedrock to any successful garden, but many people don't realise that the best time to improve your soil is right now, before winter sets in. Hi, I'm Ben, and in today's video, we're going to look at three ways to nurture your soil over winter, building its health and vitality and setting you up for a fantastic growing season next spring. How often do you see bare soil in nature? The answer is not very often, and there's a good reason for this. Bare soil is easily eroded by the elements, wind, snow, rain, and as the soil gets eroded and washed away, off go all those nutrients too. Here in the garden, covering the soil offers a number of benefits. It gives weeds a much tougher time of it, and by using organic materials, such as compost or, here, leaves, you're gradually feeding the soil, or specifically the life within the soil, which in turn feeds the crops that you grow in it. So what's the best way to build the best possible soil? Well, you don't need to buy in expensive soil amendments. Much of the way you can improve the soil is for free, or at least very cheaply. Let's start with the obvious favourites, composts and manures. Now, you should be composting absolutely everything: kitchen scraps, prunings, grass clippings, straw, cardboard leaves. Just add it all in, because it's free. And once you add a good mix of ingredients, you'll get a lovely, friable compost that smells beautiful and is a powerhouse in that garden of yours. Manure is fantastic as well, of course, but it has to be from a trusted source, because you don't want it contaminated with herbicides such as aminopyrrolid, which can easily pass through the digestive tract of a horse or cow completely intact, and then it'll inflict damage on your crops. I'm adding manure to this bed here, so it's about an inch or 3 centimetres deep. It'll keep the soil covered over winter, keeping weeds in check, and it'll give the worms something to get on and work on. And as they drag it down into the soil, the microbes will start work on it too, releasing all those nutrients in time and feeding your crop for next spring. This really is the shit. I often collect manure in the back of the car here. Now, if your car is less of a heap of junk like this and a bit tidier, you might want to put something down first. And then, of course, do save all the old potting mix bags to put the manure into. Keeps everything nice and clean. If the manure is very fresh, then you'll need to stack it somewhere out of the way for about a year, because fresh manure is too strong for most plants. Another alternative for kitchen scraps is to create a compost pit or compost trench. And this is really useful where you've got really hungry plants that will follow next summer, such as squashes or beans, climbing beans, for example. You dig a hole and then you just put your kitchen scraps in. Bung the whole lot in there. It's a bit stinky, but that's all good. And then simply cover it over. And what that'll do is, as it rots down, it creates a little pocket of fertility, really rich soil underneath there. And then in the spring, when we come to plant our squash or bean plants, we just plant it straight on top. This is one plant, that's why it's a pit. If you're creating a row of beans, for example, then dig a trench and put your compost material all along the bottom, and then cover it over. It's important to cover it over to stop it being dug up by wild animals. If you're liable to forget, just stick a stick in top on top of it so that you know where it is. Another option is to make use of organic materials that haven't yet rotted down. Grass clippings, hay, straw, for example, or at this time of year, leaves. Just spread them out onto beds and they'll get taken down. And we've made a video on this recently, so I'll pop a link to that in the video description below. For now though, I'm going to be making use of this pile of wood chips here, and it makes a fantastic mulch. Spread your wood chips out around fruit bushes, trees and canes, and because of its lovely chunky nature, this will rot down a lot slower, keeping weeds suppressed for longer and releasing its nutrients more slowly, steadily feeding your fruit plants. You can spread wood chips out onto your vegetable beds too, and I'd like to take this opportunity to dispel the myth that wood chips rob the soil of nitrogen. I guess they might, a little, if you dumped loads and loads of them onto your soil and then dug them in, but left on the surface like this, they'll do nothing but contribute their goodness into the soil, creating a lovely life-filled environment like the woodland floor. What about when you want to sow a plant? Well, no problem, just push them aside, get on and sow and plant, and then push them back around the plants once they're a bit bigger. And the third way to build soil health is to use cover crops or green manures. Cover crops are grown with the sole intention of protecting and improving soil, and they do that by keeping it covered so it's shielded from the elements, by improving soil structure through their roots, and once they're dug in or cut down, by contributing all their goodness back into the soil. Winter's not far away now, but there's one crop, super hardy crop, that can still be sown even this late, field beans. Here are the chunky seeds here. They're the same family as fava or broad beans, and they're super, super hardy. So rather than letting these produce beans, what I'll actually be doing is cutting them down before they've had a chance to produce those beans. Field beans, you see, fix nitrogen from the air at their roots. If you let them produce flowers and then produce their pods, the plants then use that nitrogen up themselves, which is why you have to cut it down before they have a chance to do that. As you can see here, all I'm doing is burying the big, fat, chunky seeds about a couple of inches or 5 centimetres into the soil. These should actually sprout before winter, and they're lovely, fat, chunky seedlings, very satisfying. I'll let them grow on till probably mid to late spring, and then they'll get chopped down. I'll leave the stumps of the plants here where they are to rot down before the next crop. And the top growth I'll remove to the compost heap. It'll make its way back here eventually, just as compost, that's all. Soil, lovely, beautiful, life-giving soil. It deserves to be treated, especially after all it's given us. Now, what's your preferred way to build soil health and vitality? Join in the conversation below. Next time, we'll be looking at perennial vegetables. Vegetables you plant once and then harvest year after year after year. Sounds good, doesn't it? If you don't want to miss that one, make sure you're subscribed and have turned on notifications. In the meantime, why not supercharge your compost making and your soil prep with these videos? I'll catch you next time.